Today I'm going to show you how to make this animation inside of Blender with shape keys. This is basically 5 different transitions merged into one. So let me show you how I made it. The first transition is going to be from a sphere to a cylinder. So let's make that first. Let's start with sphere. I'm going to make the ring size 70. And let's go into our shape keys. Add 2 shape keys. This is going to be our sphere. And the second one, it is going to be our cylinder. Now I am going to select my cylinder and tab to go into edit mode. And I'm going to select all these points and scale them on the Z axis. And I'm going to hit Z0, which is going to scale it on the Z axis. I'm going to make every point flat, which makes a cylinder. Select this, scale Z0. I'm going to scale this up a little bit to make sure that these 2 points are aligned. And we have our first transition, which goes from a sphere to a cylinder. Okay, that looks good. I'm going to name it 01. And our second transition is going to be from a cylinder to a cube. For that, I'm going to select this, Shift D to copy it. I'm going to hide 01 for now. Let's rename this to 02. And let's delete our sphere by hitting this minus button. And now the cylinder is going to be our base shape. I'm going to add, this is going to be a cube. Let's go to our top view and select all these points. Now I'm going to scale them on Y and 0. I'm going to put it over here, and again these 2 points are not aligned, so I'm going to scale it up a little bit. I'm going to select this and do the same thing, and now we have a cylinder that transforms to a cube. But right now this point is having some issues. Yeah, you can see this point and this point are not on the same axis. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select vertex ZZ and snap it to this point. The same over here. ZZ and snap it over here. Okay, now we have a perfect cube. A cylinder to cube transition. Now we can make our third transition, which is going to be a cube to a longer cube. Shift D to copy it. Let's hide 02, rename this to 03. So let's add a new shape key to this. And let's call this longer cube. And I have a reference over here. For the longer cube, I am going to go into our edit mode. Let's select all these points. With the vortex snapping points enabled, I'm going to snap it over here. Select this and snap it over here. So we got our cube to longer cube transition as well, which looks good. And now for our fourth transition, which is going to be from this longer cube back to a cylinder. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select our 02 object we made, because that is a transition from a cylinder to a cube, right? We just have to reverse it. So I'm going to select this, Shift D, and let's rename it as 04, height 02, and we have this, right? But the height is different. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to increase the height into 1.5. Yeah, that looks perfect. And now we have a longer cube to cylinder transition. And now for the final transition, which is going to be from a cylinder to a cone. I'm going to select this, Shift D, let's hide 04, let's rename this as 05, let's delete the cube, let's add a new shape key, let's rename it as 4. Let's go into our edit mode, we're going to select this, scale it down, and then select these points, scale that down, somewhere over there. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add another shape key, let's call this line, and I'm going to select this and scale that down. So the reason why I did that is because right now we have 2 controls. The first control is going to scale down the top and bottom faces of it. And the second shape key is going to control this line. Okay, so now we have all the animations in place. And now let's animate it in a such a way that it looks seamless. Because right now we have 5 different objects, right? Let's open up an editor over here. I'm going to hide everything. Let's start with 01. For 01, it starts from a sphere and goes to a cube. So let's just keyframe that. So after this, the first object should be invisible and the second object should be visible. For that, we can come in here, select our first object, come into visibility. And right now you can see this show in viewport and renders. We can keyframe these values as well. So till frame 30, it should be visible. And on frame 31, this should be invisible, right? And what should happen after frame 30? Our second object should be visible. So I'm going to select our second object and keyframe that over there. And before frame 30, that should be invisible. Right now, we are having a transition over here. Let me make the shape key 0. And right now you can see the object has been swapped, but it looks exactly the same, right? And that is the trick we are going to be using. So let's go back into our shape keys. Frame 31, it should be 0. And on frame 61, it should be 1. which makes it a transition from a cylinder to a cube. And till frame 60, this should be visible. And on frame 62, this should become invisible. On frame 61, it is visible, but on frame 62, it becomes invisible. And on frame 62, 03 should be visible. Going to keyframe it over here, and it shouldn't be visible on 61. You can see, even though the objects are being swapped, it is pretty seamless. So let's come over here, keyframe it over here. Let's go to 100. Now let's play back from the beginning and see how it looks so far. And right now you can see all the transitions are happening pretty well, even though the objects are being swapped. And let's make a couple more keyframes. Let's make this invisible over here. And let's keyframe it over here, and on 160 it should be 1. And this, let's make sure that the line from frame 145 is at 0, and maybe at frame 165 becomes 1. Okay, now let's see how the animation looks from the beginning. Okay, so that looks good. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add an empty plane axis over here and parent all these objects to this empty. Parent object, and parent object. Now, because we have parented everything to this single empty, we can animate this empty and it is going to affect all the shapes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to rotate this a little bit. I rotation, come to the end and rotate it by 360. I rotation. Right now you can see it is rotating, right? And again, because everything looks seamless, it works. And that is how I made this animation. And there is a lot more things you can tweak to make this look even better, especially the keyframe interpolations. In part 3 of this shape key series I have going on, I am going to show you how I procedurally textured this object. Thanks for watching till the end. Subscribe for more Blender tutorials.